So your shout-outs for this video goes to Brian Galeas, Expedition Ed, Jake Parker. Also, big shout-out goes to Mensis Unius, Ocean Panda, and make sure you subscribe to Smith Sinclair Family as well. They've got a great YouTube channel. Make sure you go check them out. That is it for your shout-outs. If you want one in our next video, comment it down below, and let's get into another thrilling video. Hello there, guys. My name is Coach Charles Dongster, born Bob, built for Theme Park News, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update, where today we're going to be talking about Tornado Springs and the fact that Lawrence Mansey, of course, from Poulton's Park, big shout-out to you for the image that I'll use in this video, shared an image of the Storm Chaser roller coaster in the brand new Tornado Springs section of the park. Of course, that's been delayed now until this time next year in 2021. And I'm going to be checking out some other construction updates while I talk about them over the top of that image from Twitter, talking about the latest construction updates, the finishing touches that have been made, and also share my thoughts at the end about this area for those of you who are new to the channel. But before we get started, here is how you guys can interact with Coastal YouTube channel. If you've loved this video, make sure you hit the like button below. Make sure you also comment down below your thoughts and opinions on the video topic. And also make sure you subscribe to Coastal YouTube channel for more. And click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Please share the channel with your friends, your family, and on social media. And make sure you also comment down below your video suggestions, which will be saved, your shout-outs, which will be saved for the next day's videos. And also make sure you send in your merchandise continuously on Instagram and Snapchat. The links for both are in the description down below, and I'll save your merchandise pictures with your name and location for the next merchandise showcase video. Also, make sure you get your questions in the comments down below. Use the hashtag question before or after your question, and they will be saved for our 2,000 subscriber Q&A. Also, guys, make sure you reach that subscriber goal of 10,000 subs in the next 365 days and counting. If we do that, I will release Coaster Channel merchandise on a new website, as well as other projects I've got planned for the long-term future. Let's get into another thrilling video. So in the first construction photo, we can see officially from Lawrence Mansey, big shout out to you, a look at the Storm Chaser roller coaster, which has been officially completed for a while now. And it's just sitting there waiting for brand new riders in 2021. Along with that, you can see things like one of the playgrounds in the new area, and also a little bit of a look of a wooden building or fencing with a little hut attached to the top. And that is, of course, Buffalo Falls. Moving into the second picture, and that is, of course, a few days ago, and that was the delivery of the second train. Now, of course, this is the second train for Storm Chaser, again, the Max Spinning Roller Coaster, opening in the new area, the signature new ride. But also, as well as the cars arriving for a second train for Storm Chaser, you can see the completed driving school. Now, of course, this is one of the new attractions, again, in the area. This is actually specifically replacing the old Panning for Gold attraction with the little Crazy Golf as well. But it's replacing the Panning for Gold attraction that was removed as part of a larger removal process in preparation for this brand new area. So for those of you who need a little bit of a reminder as to what is involved with this brand new area, basically, this, like I said before, this is replacing the Panning for Gold attraction, Gold Rush Falls or Gold River Falls, and also it's replacing some old animal enclosures. They have been relocated, and of course the old enclosures have been removed and demolished. Now, in terms of the rides and attractions in this area, we have Storm Chaser, which is a park's newest roller coaster manufactured by Matt Rides. It's a Sierra Sidewinder clone spinning coaster. Sierra Sidewinder is a Max spinning coaster located at Knott's Berry Farm in California. And this is a clone, or pretty much a similar clone, of that ride. So it's great for the UK visitors who haven't yet experienced Knott's Berry Farm in California yet to get a taste of what that ride system will look and feel like. As well as Storm Chaser, you also have Cyclonator, which is the park's brand new flat ride and one of the most thrilling rides in the area and in the rest of the theme park as well. It's a frisbee ride manufactured by Zamperla that swings left and right at a high angle. We also have Al's Auto Academy, which is the park's new driving school attraction. We have Windmill Towers, which is the brand new drop towers for families, similar to Tikal at Phantasialand. We have Buffalo Falls, which is the re-theme of the Wave Runner attraction that has stood at the park for many, many years. We also have the re-themed and renamed... We also have the new look re-themed Trekking Tracks attraction. We also have the Rio Grande train, which now has the name of the Rio Grande Poltons Railway. We also have Junkyard Junction and Parking Lot Tots, which are two brand new playgrounds in the area. And we also have Al's Shop and Service and Jesse's Route 83 Diner, for those of you who want to shop and eat inside the brand new Tornado Springs. So there we go, guys. That is the stats and facts on Tornado Springs for those of you who need a reminder, and also sharing the latest construction and the finishing touches being made to Tornado Springs, ready for brand new guests to come in the spring of 2021. Now, of course, we do know that the park was going to publicly launch this at the end of May. We believe they were doing some kind of VIP day, or plan to do a VIP day a couple of weeks or a week before the public launch, or like I think it's like the day, like a couple of days before the public launch. Be interesting to see when that gets rescheduled, and if there's going to be a VIP media day as well as the public launch being rescheduled for 2021. So it should be interesting to see if we're going to see the VIP media day launch rescheduled along with the public launch, or whether it's going to do a public launch. Should be interesting, and we'll keep our eyes peeled for that. But I'm very excited. Now, I was originally going to be there for the opening day this year, but of course with COVID it's been rescheduled, so obviously my plans have had to change as well. So hopefully next year I will try my best to get down there to cover the opening of this brand new area with the brand new roller coaster as well. So 2021 is going to be a mega, mega year, hopefully, if all goes to plan, because, you know, there's so many places I want to go to experience and cover the opening of brand new attractions here in the UK, with the World of David Walliams at Alton Towers, which shouldn't be too hard to get to. Thorpe Park, which is a harder one, obviously it's down near London, so that's going to be a hard trip to get to, but I want to try my best to get down there to do Black Mirror Labyrinth and experience the opening of that and give you my review from the park itself. Same with Chessington, my first ever visit to Chessington World of Adventures. It needs to happen as soon as possible, especially with the brand new Croc Drop. That's the trademarked name for the brand new drop tower that's opening there next year. So I want to try and get down there as soon as possible to do coverage for that. Blackpool Pleasure Beach, they're reopening Valhalla in 2021 if all goes to plan. So hopefully I want to try and get down to Blackpool for the first time in a few years to cover the launch of Valhalla. And the relaunch of Valhalla, so fingers crossed that goes to plan. And of course this, Tornado Springs, reopening in opening in 2021, rescheduled from 2020 at Poulton's Park. So, you know, that's five openings, five major openings in the UK that I want to get down to next year, which obviously, realistically, in this current climate, not all of them will be achievable. But I hope to God at least two, maybe three, if I'm lucky, will be achievable. And I hope Tornado Springs is one of them. So I'll try my best to get down to all five, but if there's any I can't get down to, it's not the end of the world. But overall, what I will say is that Tornado Springs is definitely one of the projects I'm most excited for, because of the fact that it's a whole themed area. It's got this whole Western town theme. It's got a full backstory. And I've said it in the past, the park have got themselves a bargain investment, because all they had to replace for this brand new area is the old Panning for Gold with the crazy golf attractions added together. I think it's called Gold Rush Falls or Gold River Falls, one of those two, I can't remember exactly. But that's been around since, I think it was 2007? It was either 2003 or, no, it was 2003 and then 2007 was the Wave Runner first opening. It's between those 2 years. It's either 2003 or 2007, because the other one was the opening of the Wave Runner, which I believe was 2003. So, thinking about it, 2003 and then 2007 was the Gold Rush Falls. So Obviously, a Panning for Gold Crazy Gold of Attraction combined. It's an interesting combination, but it wasn't really going to last if you wanted to make bigger, better investments. And of course, to improve your animal enclosures on the plus side as well, that is always a bonus, to improve the enclosures for your animals. I think it was the pelicans and the flamingo enclosures they had to demolish and relocate them and make them better enclosures, so that's always a plus sign. But to replace a crazy golf attraction, a panning for gold attraction, and a couple of old animal enclosures, which can easily be replaced by better ones somewhere else in the park, is a bargain in my eyes, especially when you're putting in new flat rides, new family rides, refurbished attractions, new restaurant, new shop, and a brand new spinning coaster. I would guarantee that a bargain in my eyes. So I'm very excited. Obviously, from the construction side, we know that finishing touches are being made. There's no real massive construction still yet to do. I think if we're looking at it from a percentage point of view, I believe maybe about 80% is done now. Maybe 80 to 85% around that mark. I think just to be on the safe side, if we're rounding it off to 10, I'm going to go between 75 to 85% done. That's the realistic percentage of what we're looking at here. 75 to 85% done. Could be more, could be less. But from the looks of it, it looks pretty much nearly done. I think just a little added touches here and there, and it will be ready for 2021. So I'm really excited for this area. I hope you guys are really excited as well. I can't wait to see if we get to go to this area next year in the, when it opens for the public launch, or before the public launch, maybe, if we're lucky. And yeah, it's going to be interesting. So obviously, this is a series that we've covered for quite a while. I've covered Tornado Springs ever since the channel first started. You know, it was the first couple of months of the channel before we came into 2019, let alone 2020. It was before we came into the year 2019 when I started this flaming channel. And I started covering Tornado Springs videos. So, you know, it's been a massive series to cover. And it's been a privilege doing these videos as well as every other video on the channel. So it's gonna be an emotional opening, and obviously people are gonna be like, well, why is it an emotional opening? It's a family area with a family thrill coaster and a couple of thrill rides. You know, it's nothing, you know, for thrill seekers to be crying about. It's not just the area and the look of the area, it's what we've done on the channel with this. It's the fact that we've covered this, we've done construction updates, marketing announcements, the official announcement of the area and the name and the attractions in the area, you know, the rumours, the speculation, shouting out the engineering team at Poulton's in one video. That was always a massive plus for me. They always love watching these videos. So it's been, you know, it's going to be around about, you know, 2 years nearly of coverage by the time this opens. So it's been a privilege, and it's been a wild ride, let's just say that. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this news update. We'll see if there's more construction updates over the next few months as we head into getting closer into 2021 and close to the reopening of the opening of the area. Don't know why I keep saying reopening, probably because it's a delayed 2020 attraction, but obviously when it gets closer to the 2021 opening, we're going to get hopefully some more updates, like opening dates and things like that, and hopefully maybe I'd love to speak to the park. I'd love to speak to someone at the park about this project at some point, so we'll see what happens with that. But for now, guys, thank you very, very much. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and for now, guys, my name is Coast Shell. Keep on the coast of life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.